And if that means taking the path less traveled and standing up for something that maybe a lot of other people wouldn't stand up for, then do it. As long as it is in alignment with how you feel and who you are. Hello, beautiful warriors. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so excited to have you watching this video on the Aquarius full moon happening on August 3rd. If you're excited to learn about it, make sure that you hit the like button. And if you aren't subscribed already, hit the subscribe button so you get notified of when I post videos just like this, because I post every single Tuesday and I talk about astrology and spirituality and self-development and shadow work. Now let's dive into the video. Now, I may be totally biased because I'm a double Aquarius, but I really love the Aquarius-Leo opposition. And naturally, when we have a full moon, I've said this before, but I'll say it again, we have an opposition between the sun and the moon. So essentially, during a full moon, the sun shines all of its light on the moon, exposing the moon. And that's why the full moon is associated with exposing things that have been underneath the surface and have caused things to surface that have kind of been hidden and unseen. Aquarius really rules things around general themes like it's really tapped into technology, it's very futuristic, it's very into humanitarian causes, it's very rebellious. And the reason why it's so rebellious is because it is very adamant about being authentic to the self. It's very adamant about taking the road less traveled, if that means that it is in alignment with you and your true essence and who you are. And so when it comes to this full moon exposing things that are kind of underneath the surface, Aquarius is very tapped into this humanitarian sort of energy. And so I thought that this was really interesting around what's happening with, you know, this is a hard topic, but what's happened with George Floyd and what's happened around things being exposed that have been underneath the surface around racism. Now, this does fall into the Aquarian sort of theme because Aquarian is so into protecting human life. It values human life more than anything. It fights for humanitarian causes. It is the advocate for amongst all of the signs. It is the rebel. It is the sign that sticks up for the oppressed. And so this is a really beautiful moon because it really is asking us and inviting us to kind of tap into our own individual expressions and our own individual experiences around what's happening in humanity. Aquarius is so tapped into the collective. It's tapped into the bigger picture and how one thing can affect all of us as a collective, as a tribe. And so it really is inviting us to take a look at our part in that. It'll be a really great time. Leo, because we're in Leo season and Leo rules the heart, so it'll be a really great time to tap into your heart and to really kind of go within and see what has come up for you in response to what is happening in our world, what's happening in society. Aquarius wants to rebel against what is not working. It wants to change things. It sees what's not working in the collective and it rebels against it and it says, this is not working for us. In the future, we need to push forward and we need to do things different. And that is why Aquarius is so linked to being eccentric and unique and a little weird, because it's tapped into futuristic energies and it's very ahead of its time. It's tapped into the collective and it's tapped into what the collective needs at that particular time, which may actually look a little weird, you know, to the rest of humanity, because it comes up with these very innovative solutions that people don't really understand at the time because it's so ahead of their time. And so during this time, it's a really good thing to take a look at what's coming up for you emotionally and what is being mirrored in you as a result of what we're going through as a collective. Because when it comes to racism, when it comes to these really tough topics that we've been facing as a tribe, as a collective, it tends to bring up pieces around shame. It tends to bring up anger and sadness and all of those things. And it tends to bring up experiences that we've had in our own lives that have really mirrored the ugliness of what is happening. Also, Neptune has been retrograde and it will be retrograde for a little while longer. And so it's really an amazing time to look at the deception that has been happening, right? Neptune can be very, very deceiving. And it's not from a malicious place. It's from a place of wanting to believe something fantastical, wanting to it's kind of stuck in the dream world of what it wants to be a reality versus what's actually happening, what's actually a reality. And I think that there's been a lot of that happening in our country around what's been happening with Black Lives Matter and George Floyd. And there's been this underlying dishonesty and deception and just sweeping things underneath the rug. And now it's been exposed. And so we're really being challenged to take a look at where that's happening within us and take a look at where Aquarius is in your own chart. Take a look at the house that it's in and what area of life that corresponds to, because that'll give you insight into what's happening for you on an individual level. And so we're really being asked to take a look at those pieces around where we've been lying to ourselves, where there's kind of been a little bit of deception, where we've been sweeping things underneath the rug. And not to mention that the sun and moon will be making a T-square to Uranus. And Uranus is, again, it's all about being true to yourself. It rules Aquarius. And so it really challenges you to step into your authentic self and to express your individuality. And if that means taking the path less traveled and standing up for something that maybe a lot of other people wouldn't stand up for, then do it. As long as it is in alignment with how you feel and who you are, that is really what Uranus wants to teach us. It doesn't want you to be it doesn't want you to follow the sheeple. It doesn't want you to be a sheep. It wants you to be a lion, right? We're in Leo season. So find your authority and find what makes you feel like a lion and what makes you feel like an individual and stand in your authentic expression. But in order to do that, in order to really stand in your authentic expression, you have to peel away the parts of you that are a lie, that are complete deception. And we all have things like that going on in our lives. So what are the things in your life that are not in alignment with your true expression? And how are you playing it small and you're not actually letting yourself go big? And really show up the way that you want to show up? What are the parts in your life that are just a complete lie? Specifically, because Venus is involved with this Neptune retrograde, specifically focus on what do you truly value and what are you lying to yourself around your values and your beliefs? Oftentimes what happens is we take on other people's values or we lie about what we want or what we truly value or what we see for ourselves in the future in order to stay small, because the ego tries to protect us. It's all about this sort of survival mechanism. But to look into the future, there's an opportunity here to be playful and to let your imagination sort of soar a little bit. And to, like I said, we're in Leo season, which really corresponds to playful energy and childlike energy and curiosity. And if you haven't watched my video on the approach of Leo season, there's also the new moon in Cancer in Leo season. Definitely go watch it because it'll give you some more perspective on this Leo energy. But there's an opportunity here to play around with our future and to really idealize. Aquarius is all about ideas. It's an air sign. It's all about the mind and intellect, and it's very idealistic. It's not very practical. It comes up with these grand solutions that are very idealistic, and everybody just kind of is confused, is left confused about it because nobody gets Aquarius. But so it's asking you to play, like, and to sort of plan for your future in a way where it's like, okay, if you could have whatever it is that you wanted, if you could be truly real with yourself, be authentic with what it is that you want. No playing small, no selling yourself short. If you could have anything that you want, what would it be? And to really play with that, to look at that as childlike wonder, and to idealize, to really step into the fantasy of that. Because again, Neptune is involved here. And so there is room to dream, right? Aquarius is also a dreamer. Like it likes to project into the future. So there's a lot of really juicy things to play around with here. But at the same time, there's also energy playing out around being really real with yourself and also assessing how you're showing up for yourself and in turn how you're showing up for the collective, because how we treat ourselves, how we love ourselves, how we go within and do the reflection work, whatever level work we're doing, is going to show up in the external world. And so you can see that in an individual level and a collective level in the way that things are being exposed around what we've been going through with racism and all of those things. And now we're really being forced to do the work. We're being forced to do the shadow work. We're being forced to take a look at where we've been deceiving ourselves and to actually do something about it, to transform. This is no longer okay. This isn't okay on a collective scale, and it's also not okay on an individual scale. And this is what Aquarius really teaches us. It's saying it is not okay for you to not value your own life and to not value the life of someone else. We are all one. And it's not okay to just lie to yourself and keep yourself small and treat yourself poorly and to sweep things underneath the rug, because it will end up showing up in your external world and it will show up in how the way you treat your tribe. And Aquarius is all about your tribe. So during this time, you can also share your experiences with your friends. Aquarius is all about friendship and sharing. Sharing what it has to offer in a tribe setting. And so you can really lean on your friends as a resource during this time. The last thing that I wanted to mention here is there are multiple T-squares playing out, and another T-square that is playing out involves the retrograde stellium in Capricorn. And Capricorn has to do with the government. It has to do with systems and rules and authority. And so you can see this again on a much larger scale, but you can also look at it on an individual scale as well. Aquarius oftentimes rebels against systems that aren't working, specifically that systems that aren't working, rules that aren't working. It will break rules that don't make sense and don't serve the people and don't serve humanity. And so take a look at the systems that are playing out in your life that you can feel yourself rebelling against, that you can feel yourself not agreeing with, and that are actually holding you back from tapping into your heart space and holding you back from showing up for yourself and being authentic and standing in the way of what you truly value and what truly matters. That is huge right now. And it's, again, it's huge on a collective scale too. If we take a look at what's happening, we're seeing these sort of authoritative powers, the holes in it, the holes in the system, and how it's impacting us as a collective, and how it's really reflective of very corrupt values that are based upon lies, right? Like, no life is any less valuable than another. And so there's that energy is very, very present right now. So take a look at what's happening within you around the systems that you're letting control you, or the systems that are in place in your life that are not really reflecting your self-worth and not really reflecting how you actually want to be showing up in the world and how you want to be showing up for other people and yourself. So some pretty powerful concepts at play here. And like I said, I'm probably super biased because I have a lot of Aquarius in my chart. But I think that this is a really amazing opportunity to kind of tap into the part of the moon cycle, the routine of the moon cycle, and this particular archetype, this particular spot on the wheel is asking us to do some work that can really make waves. It can really shift things and change things. Aquarius is all about change. It's all about pushing things forward, and it's very proactive in helping anything that feels oppressed or doesn't feel in alignment with truth and love. And so it's really quite amazing, and I hope that you guys have an amazing full moon. Please let me know what you're doing in the comment box below. I would love to know how you're going to be celebrating this full moon. Also, stay posted for the article that I'm writing for Tamed Wild. I will be sure to include some rituals that you can do during this time to kind of tap into the self-development and the shadow work pieces around this full moon and the topics that were discussed today in this video. So I hope you guys like this video. Like it if you really liked it. Share it with anybody who you feel like could benefit from it. And I will also include an Etsy link in the caption below to my shop, so you can book an astrology reading with me if you're wanting to kind of sit down with me and go through your chart and do some shadow work. I offer those things as well as some magical goodies in my shop. So I hope you guys have a good full moon, and I hope to see you for the next video.